Dear friends, welcome to my video. In this video, I'll show you how to take a screenshot from your Android 11 app. So let's begin. As usual, I'll create a very simple layout and I'll just name it screenshot Android 11 app. Yeah, you can name it anything. And then rest of the things looks fine. Over here, language probably I'll choose Java. And of course, I'll use the Android 11 API level 30. That's the intention for this particular app. And let me click finish and wait for the IDE to load up. Once the IDE loads up, then this kind of window will come up. First and foremost, we will just update our manifest file. We'll ask for some user's permission. And that's one is read external storage and the other one is write external storage. We'll need this because we will be saving our screenshots. So we'll just use this in our Java code also, or probably we can do that as the first thing. So in this, in the own create method itself, what we can do is we can use the activity compat dot request permission, and we can use this method to request permission. And the first attribute is of course the activity, the first attribute. And then the second will be to give the permissions, the name of the permissions which we will seek from the users. So we will just give the name as manifest.permission.writeExternalStorage, and what else we'll need also the manifest.permission.readExternalStorage. Yeah, these two are the permissions which we will need. And the third argument will be to grant permission. Permission granted. Yeah. So this line will enable us to ask permission from the end user. And also I'll make a method public void, not returning anything. And this method probably we can name is button screenshot. Again, you can name this anything, and we'll use the standard, not the virtual machine, sorry, view, and yeah, some argument as view. Perfect. Now we'll go to the layout first. The XML, basically the XML file, or the you can directly do in the code part, or you can do in the design part as well. It will be fine. So I'll keep the layout pretty simple. I just use one button here, and I'll just keeping it simple and straightforward. So, and I just name this button as screenshot. Perfect. The few warnings, I think it should be for the hardcore text. Yeah. The screenshot word, so it will just create a resource for that in the resource folder. That's fine. Just click fix and it will take care internally. That's all from layout perspective. No, one more thing, in this button we can associate this button with the method in the on click attribute. Just come down here and select this particular attribute. It will get associated with this particular method. So whenever that particular button is pressed, this particular method will be called. Is called screenshot, I think, because there's a triple E. I'll just remove one E, but then make sure you go back here in the layout and change it, because this method does not exist anymore. Yeah, so yeah, perfect. Okay, now over here, this is the main method which we'll use to do our things. So here we are already getting the view of the particular app. So this will give determine the view of the button which is calling this. So what we can do is we can create another view, probably view one, and we can use this view to get the root. So get root view. So this will give me the root, the view of the complete screen. We'll see it shortly. So this is one approach. Other one, probably I can also show one another approach, is what we can do is we can use view two, or we'll name this also view one. I'll just comment out that one. And what we can do it is over here is we can get the window. And then we can get the root from this decor view, and then the get root view. Yeah. So this will also return me the complete layout view. So we can try anything. So probably I'll comment on this also. I'll try first with this option. So once we have the root view, then we will have to create it or draw it on a canvas. So for this, first we'll create a bitmap, and what we can do it is bitmap. Dot bitmap dot create bitmap, of course, and then the source will be okay. So first we will have to give our dimension of this bitmap what we are trying to create. So what we can do is probably we can use this view one and get the width. So first one will be of course the width. We are using this one probably the we'll use this particular method, the override method over here. And then we'll use the get height, and the third and the last argument could be the configuration we may have to give. So we'll just give some kind of configuration, say for example bitmap dot config dot any value you can choose. Probably I'll go for RGB 800. Yeah, so once we have it, then what we will do is probably, okay, I'm not sure why the semicolon went to the second line, I might have pressed enter, that's fine. And now we'll create a canvas. So and canvas, and we'll use the above bitmap to create this canvas. So bitmap, and no, I think it should have been not new bitmap, it should have been new canvas, sorry. Yeah, okay, so once we have this canvas created, then we can use this canvas to draw our view, whatever view we have. So what we can use is simply view1.draw, and we will give the above canvas. So make sure this canvas dimensions, the dimension which we have given, matches what we are trying to draw here, otherwise it may not come nicely. Okay, so once we have it, then what we can do is probably we can just create a file output stream, and output stream, and this one we can use. Okay, first of course we'll just initialize it with null, and we, this one we can use to write our whatever we have drawn in this canvas. We can try to flush it on that particular particular file. So but what we'll do is we'll probably use some kind of try catch, because there will be IO exception thrown. So all I'm using just exception, but you can you can use IO exception anyway. When you write, it will make it mandatory for you to use or initialize try catch over here. Okay, anyway, if I proceed, so the file output stream what we have created above, so we can create a new file output stream. For that we'll need a file name. So let's create a new file over here. So let me just comment out this line for the timing and go back. I'll create a file at the out only. So file, and probably we can name it file screenshot. You can name anything again. So here it will be, so new and file, and so over here we'll use something called as get external files directory, which will be specific to this app. I'll show you in the actual run also. And then string type could be either you can keep it null also or any type. And probably we know that since we will be storing the pictures here, so why not to have the directory pictures here. And then what else we'll need is we'll probably need a file name which we can append to it. So since we'll take lots of pictures, why not to use the system time timestamp to capture the timing when it was got. So we'll use the get instance and get probably time, and we'll just convert it into to string. Yeah, that should be fine. And probably we'll just so do something like we'll add the extension jpg, or you can just skip it also, but it will be good because I think I'll just bring this in the second line. Yeah, good. So this JPG will be good if you're exporting that file somewhere else over WhatsApp or something, it will really help you out. Okay, so once we have this file and output stream, now I'll go back here, and over here in this file output stream, I'll just create new file output stream, and I'll give the file name as the one which we have just now created. And once we have that, then we can use our bitmap to write it on this particular file. So we can just do what is compress, and the format will be probably bitmap compress.jpg, and what else then we can have is probably the quality and the output stream which we have just now created above. Perfect. So I think more or less we are done here. Just to close it, flush this one, and also we can close this dot close. Yeah, perfect. So I think more or less it's done. And I can see it's giving this warning, so why not to bring this creation also inside is what I'm thinking here. And we don't need this particular line here. Perfect. So this makes it much better because now everything is within the try catch and looks good. Yeah, so we'll run this and we have two view options. So first we'll go with the first view and let's see how it comes out, and we'll wait for our emulator to come up. In the meantime, I'll do a little bit of cleaning here. Perfect, so it's better to keep the code compact so that it's more readable. In cached part, you can implement whatever logic you want to implement, but for the simplicity, I'm just leaving it blank for a time being over here. And yeah, looks good. So I think our emulator has also come up in the meantime. And what it's saying is asking me to allow our app to access the photos and media on our device. Of course, click allow. And then click press this screenshot, and I assume it has taken screenshot because we have not used this text view to update our status or something. So I assume that, and now what we'll do is we'll go and check whether a screenshot has been created or not. So just go to the files menu and go to level up. Okay, probably I can show you from the start. You should go to inside this in your files options, go to the SDK phone 86 and over here go inside, I think Android, and then data, and here you'll get the data of all the apps which you have created. And one by one, I mean there are lots of folders you can see. So I think our app name, what you can do it is you can go and to the top, so this will be same as the folder name, so com.programmerworld. So if I go back to my emulator, so says I can say wait, why not, and over here I can see most of the top one is from Google, but here it starts, so I assume this is my folder. So if you read here, com.programmerworld dot screenshot, and so probably this is the one which I'm looking for. Then go inside the files and of course the pictures. So if you can see, it's just now created. The time with the timestamp, you can guess it. And if I double click and open, perfect. So this is the what the screenshot of our app is all about. Okay, got it. Yeah, just click got it. And we can also probably, yeah. So what we can do it is we can go back to our app. For some reason it seems not working, so I'm not sure why this home button is not working. I wanted to go to the home button and then wanted to see all the options which I have, but none of them are coming. So I think I may have to restart the app, but no problem. What we'll do it is this time we'll use the second option, see if this works or not. But also I'll do one thing, I'll just first switch this option. So I'll just comment out that and uncomment this. It's control slash which we have to press the shortcut key from the keyboard to uncomment this and comment that line. So now it should work similarly, but I will also like to use the my text view in the layout to print something. So I'll just give this some ID, probably text view, and I go back to my Java code, and over here probably what we will do is I'll just create a class variable, private class variable of course, and that will be my text view, and in my own create I will just text view equal to find view by id r dot id dot, yeah, text view. So this gets associated, my local variable in the Java gets associated with the one with the in the layout. Coming back here, what we can do it is if everything is fine, we can just say over here, or probably we can say it at the end after this close, text view set text success, otherwise over here we can print failure, set text failure. And probably just to make sure, in the start over here we'll put text view set text starting, so we'll know that whether it went till, okay, I should have given this as starting, So if it's success, then it means it has done all the code in success. And if it's failure, okay, I can make it probably failure. Yeah, if it fails, it will come here. And if it, otherwise, it will just code on the starting. That means something is broken in between over here. Perfect. So we will just stop this, probably this app, and rerun it. We'll probably bring it side by side like this, yeah, so that you can see both the things. And I think my app has restarted. And this time, if I press, it says success. That means it has come to this line number 52. Perfect. And if I try to go now again, so in my file menu, okay, if you see, one more particular file has come up. So previously that was the one, now it has come this one. And if I double click and see, a starting, it comes a starting because I don't know why system UI is failing, but I'll just click on wait. So what is happening is, first thing it does is it sets a starting over here, and then it captures at this line number 43 is what it captures the view, and then it starts writing. So in the app, although we see success, but the point of time when it is capturing, that time the app has the word called starting. That's why the starting keyword has come here. You can even print some dynamic text here to come up. Okay, so I hope so both are working, this and the other one. Probably I will just again comment, uncomment that and comment this out just for last try and to see how it comes up. And then success, of course. And I go to my home, come here. And one more has come up, one more screenshot. Of course, it will keep a feeling. And this is also starting because, of course, same. So that's all I wanted to show. It's pretty simple and straightforward. You have to just take the root view and then print it or draw it on a canvas. Just make sure that canvas has the same dimension of the view. And then you have to just put it or on an output stream on a file using the file output stream. That's all. So I hope this video is useful. If you have any questions or suggestions, then please put in the comment section. And if you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel. Thank you and have a nice day.